Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. If m and n are positive integers, 1 plus 1 half plus 1 third plus until plus 1 over 100 equals m over n, is m divisible by 101? Let's simplify first. We group each two items from right-hand side in the following way. The first one and the last one. The second one and the second from last. The third one and the third one from last. And until the middle twos. Why are we doing this? Let's consider the common denominator for each sum. The first denominator, that's 1 times 100. The numerator is 100 plus 1. For the second sum, the common denominator, that's 2 times 99. The numerator, that's 99 plus 2. Until the last one, the common denominator, that's 50 times 51. The numerator there is 51 plus 50. Continue to simplify. You can find each numerator of the right-hand side is 101. Next thing we want to do is to get rid of all denominators from both left-hand side and the right-hand side. The denominator from the left-hand side is n. The common denominator of the right-hand side is n factorial. Why is n factorial? We have 1, we have 2, we have 3, we have 50, 51, 52, until 100. This implies the common denominator of the right-hand side is n factorial. It is 1 times 2 times 3 until 100. In order to get rid of the denominators from both left-hand side and right-hand side, both sides, times n times n 100 factorial. The left-hand side is m times 100 factorial. N cancel this n. The right-hand side, we have n here, 100 times each one. 100 times the first one, we have 101 here, and 100 factorial. And denominator, that's 1 times 100. We can cancel some. For example, 100 cancel. Actually, that's 99 factorial. We use M1 for 99 factorial. Similarly, here we have 100 here, 100 factorial. 2 can cancel 2, 99 can cancel 99. Both factors we have from 100 factorial. We use the remaining part as M2. For the last term, 100 factorial, we can cancel 50 from the denominator, 51 from denominator. The remaining part, we use M50. According to this cancellation, we imply m times 100 factorial equals n times those sums. Certainly for sum m1, m2, until m50. Next thing, we can factor 1 out. M times 100 factorial equals n times 1 times the sum of the remaining part. Is this m divisible by 1? We're not sure. Because here we have 100 factorial. Do we have some factors? We can cancel from 101 and 100 factorial? No. Because 101 is a prime number. That means 101 only has two factors, 101 and 1. So here, 100 factorial does not have a factor of 101. So here, this implies m is divisible by 101. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.